Right, very excited for this clip. This is the latest
clip. I haven't done in a while with any this new stuff in it, really. I did one, like a teaser of it, and compression has changed the way I adjusted it. Initially, it was just on the attack, and it had no real squashing going on to the rest of the note. So here we have it fully adjustable. There's two pots in the back and a switch in the back, and then there is a switch, sorry, a pot right here, which is currently on 5. I'm going to adjust the front pot in a bit. Let's see what's going on here with that in terms of compression. That is the old Shakedown 135 with this new implementation, including some other tricks I got going on. I really don't want to get into it right now, but that's really all I'm going to say. This thing sounds awesome for really ripping it. It's a nice overdrive. The master volume. I got the volumes around 6.5. Yep, 6.5, and then mastered only on 3. Put up a little bit of delay on. Got a Tube Screamer TS9, original one from the 80s. Maybe I'll throw it on. Got a Neutron 3 here. As per usual, except we have the South Coal coils active in this video. This amp really loves the South Coil, that's all I could say. A lot of amps can't do that and present it in a kind of a warm, driving fashion. This one absolutely does. It's a match made in heaven. That's what I dialed this for currently. So compression is basically only on a little bit. Sure, it does a little bit more to this note. Size and position. country players or pedal steel players. Excellent. Sing to it. Lots of nice sustain. Not that you need that on a pedal steel, but sure would be nice with a lap steel. Bring the volume down a little bit, like I said initially.